Today is a build day for our Go Baby Go program.
Fire away.
What we'll be doing is building two cars for two specific kiddos and modifying the seating for those kiddos.
We take a typical car that you could buy from any store and we rewire it so that they don't have to use a foot pedal because a lot of our kiddos don't have the ability to use a foot pedal. Once we rewire it, they move the car by pressing a button, which is a lot easier for most of our kids. And then we kind of adapt the car so that they have enough support to be able to sit in the car by themselves.
If a kiddo has some issues with skin irritation, we might use their wheelchair cushion as their seat, but then add other modifications like side supports with pool noodles or kickboards or anything that we can come up with that's kind of a cheaper way to modify something that's appropriate for this kiddo. Our program is run a little bit differently than some of the other chapters around the country. We've involved some students from a gifted program at Cedar Crest High School. They come in, they help us with the build, we're kind of supervising them and they have to brainstorm and figure out how to do it based on the directions we give them, ask for help when they need to. So it's a really great opportunity for them to kind of expand their knowledge and kind of see if it's something they're interested in as a career path.
Elise was born with a very rare genetic disease in which we have seen very significant developmental delays from that. I'm hoping that it gives her a sense of independence, and she has two older brothers who are very active and play in the neighborhood a lot for many hours. So I'm hoping to give Elise the chance to play alongside with them and just enjoy herself out in the community with their friends.
Oh my goodness, she's doing it!
We want to start Go Baby Go because we've seen the impact that it has on other kids in the country. Myself and Emily have done Go Baby Go in other hospitals before. And we've seen that the kids, you know, they open up a little bit more. They engage more with kids their age. They're able to play with their siblings. They're able to get around their backyard for the first time without being in their wheelchair or being carried by somebody. You see the social aspect and then you see just kind of their personalities come out a little bit more. And that's a really big deal for children with disabilities.